Well, ladies and gentlemen, more news for you guys, and we are definitely going to come up with Willian is definitely leaving Arsenal, and of course the injury report is here. We're going to address that as well. We're also going to address a lot of things. Lucas Torreira's option to buy, visit or a move to Fiorentina is almost all but confirmed, which will be done very soon. Mikel Arteta gives his verdict about how exactly are they doing and what exactly is the depth of the malaise that lies at Arsenal. That also will be addressed as of now. And as we speak, let's just talk about the injuries that Arsenal are facing at the moment. So, Hector Bellerin, Lacazette, Magalhães, Gabriel Martinelli, Alex Onarsson and Kieran Tierney have all returned to full training ahead of Wednesday's game. Good news. Eddie Nketiah is out until early September. Thomas Partey is working hard with the medical team and is aiming to be back in training by the end of August. Martin Odegaard has received full clearance to play and is available for selection. Ben White will not be available for Wednesday's game. His health and fitness will be continually monitored ahead of the weekend as well. So we see how exactly things will take place. Well, let's see. And Martin Odegaard is available for selection as well. Now, contradictory statements, but according to Jorge Barroel, he says that Willian has terminated his contract with Arsenal. His future will be at Corinthians. So Willian's future will be at Corinthians as we speak. So according to that news, but Chris Wheatley. Yeah, Fabrizio tweeted out that Corinthians proposal for Willian is on the table since yesterday. Contract offered until 2023 or 2024. Talks ongoing on salary situation as Arsenal are prepared to let Willian leave on a free move. Willian's priorities for European clubs, but Corinthians are confident they will get a job done. And according to GE Globo, they say that Willian had a conversation with Edu and exposed a series of dissatisfaction with the club's project that's motivated him to ask to leave. His wish was accepted and Arsenal are open to releasing the Brazilian. And finally, I think it's the best thing. I mean, see, I know certain transactions or deals are flop. You know, fans would say, hey, look, I told you it flopped. Yeah, fine. I know. But to get rid of Willian is nothing more than a miracle. And I really want to, you know, if Willian deal gets off, I think I'm pretty much happy for the fact that Willian does not want to sit and take those wages. He wants to fight for his place, and if he's not happy, he doesn't stay. And that is what he's actually trying to say with this straightaway thing that he told to Edu that he wants to leave. And I think I respect that. That's really good. If the move has not favored you, nor the fans, nor the club, I think it's the best is to part ways. And I think he really had a wonderful. Yeah, I think it's a very good decision. And thank God he's not sitting off and feasting on those wages. But moving on, so Arsene Wenger was seen visiting Liverpool's training today at Kirkby, and this is what gifted him. And of course, you could see Liverpool players with the man himself, Papa Wenger. And there we go. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen, Virgil van Dijk. Every single one of them talking to the man himself. Well, just when you think Arsenal are still, a lot of fans are actually recovering from the fact that the new kit has burnt a hole in their pockets. Adidas are about to release another, and this time it would be a 2006 inspired line featuring a colorway that is reminiscent of the iconic 2005-2006 Highbury Farewell home kit. It'll be available in November or December. Well, the new jersey conveys very strong Teamgeist 2006 vibes and also evokes strong memories of Arsenal's home kit of 2005 and 2006. So there you have it. That is exactly what it is going to be. And crazy as it sounds, lovely. And according to Marco Dell'Olio, Torreira's loan to Fiorentina is the option to buy, not an obligation. okay, because also we have a confirmation from AFC Bell that Homero Torreira, Lucas Torreira's older brother, tells AFC Bell that the player agreed with Fiorentina on personal terms. Arsenal and Fiorentina have agreed in principle on a one-year loan, and the two clubs are still talking about what the clause will be included and whether it will be an option to buy or an absolute buyout or restricted to £15 million. That's what Bell says. Bell also says that and Lucas Torreira shared this image that he's flying to Italy. The clubs are actually still talking about the final details, but yes, he is off to Italy. On his Instagram stories, Lucas Torreira shared this. Off to Italy is what I get the message from it. So there we go. And these are the Tutto Sports Golden Boy 2021 Final 60 with Bukayo Saka, Gabriel Martinelli and William Saliba having their names in them. Tutto Sport. Yeah, like that's AFC Bell also have a opening about Lacazette. They say a source close to Lacazette tells them that the player's survival and continuity with Arsenal this season is more likely than his departure, unless an opportunity arises that cannot be missed in the remaining time of the market. There are no signs at the moment of any convergence of views between the club and the player's camp regarding its continuation beyond the current season. So no new contract, no club buying, and Obazette stay. That's the headline, boys. Well, WWE superstar Drew McIntyre spoke to Sohail Malik, who's an Al Jazeera English sports reporter. He says back in the 90s, it was actually SummerSlam of WWE. So he says back in the 90s, I enjoyed Arsenal. Seaman was in goal. How upset I was when Naeem scored that one goal, and Bergkamp is one of my favorite players ever. Arsenal have always been part of my life. I knew I should always love AFC Bell, man. Sorry, Drew McIntyre. I think I'm drunk at the moment, but okay. Mikel Arteta says, and I quote, "This is a project that is going to take some time. You can see and tell from the recruitment that what we've done and the really young squad that we have at the moment, and it cannot happen overnight." It's really cool. Of course it cannot happen overnight, but yeah. Well, talking about Scotland squad versus Germany, Moldova and Austria, Kieran Tierney has been included in the Scotland squad for the World Cup qualifiers next month. Now, my biggest problem is Arsenal should not let him go, man. Come on. No way he's in. No way. Why would... See, that I don't know what's more painful. Arsenal's form or the upcoming international break, man. They need to take a break from international breaks. I'm really pissed at the moment, man. It just does not make any sense anymore. But moving on, Gary Neville has opened up about Arsenal. He says, "They've got young players you can imagine are committed, desperate to do well, got the talent. I think about the guidance I got at Man United from unbelievable senior players. I don't think they've got the right direction around them and the right structure. They have got a good, they have got a young coach as well with a massive job in front of him. And I feel that there is something missing there that will give the young players the ability to go and achieve what they want." Yeah. Well, Arsenal were completely linked for this Everton guy named Thierry Small, and I've been literally reporting it in the last two windows that how Arsenal are very much wanting to bring in Thierry Small, but Southampton have confirmed the signing of Thierry Small after his exit from Everton. 17-year-old guy has signed a three-year deal, the maximum allowed for a player of his age. The Saints have a fullback in Thierry Small. Well, and as per Sami Mokbel of Daily Mail, he says that Willian in talks over a move to Corinthians on a free transfer, told deal moving quickly. That was actually tweeted by Jack Rosser, who's a football writer for Standard Sport. And so those are the two departures that you are going to see in the nearest and dearest future. Still on I am on the midst that of course we're going to make two more signings minimum. But still, that totally depends upon how many departures are going to take place. But If Arsenal are going to go into the whole season with Thomas Partey, Xhaka, Sambi Lokonga and Elneny as the options, they'd better get one more. They'd really want one more. They should get one more. With this, I'd like to end this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you see daily Arsenal content, best place to be, consider subscribing. Cheers.